The Acer Liquid JDS is Acer's new mid-range smartphone. It's said to offer pretty much everything you want from a smartphone at about half the price of current Android flagships. You won't be wrong to ask, excellent, but where are the caveats? So go on with our review, we will explain. Understated and sleek, this is how we describe the Liquid JDS design and those are words you rarely hear for a budget device. It's not the build materials that make this smartphone special though, it's the curves. The JDS has an intensely rounded body comprising two layers. It starts with a non-removable plastic back panel that feels sturdy, carefully sculpted with a smooth, matte finish. Acer also topped off the smartphone with curved glass, which completes its liquid flowing appearance. The layers are held together by a thin chrome frame. Speaking of thin, the Acer Liquid JDS is 0.3 inches thick and is light as a feather at 4.09 ounces. On the top edge of the phone, you'll find a 3.5mm audio jack, while the volume buttons are positioned to the right. They're not of very good quality though. It's a small plastic stripe that never feels quite right. It lacks the clickiness to make it feel responsive enough, and the volume minus key tends to get stuck at times, which is a major flaw. The volume plus key has been made slightly convex, as to let your finger recognize it more easily. Unfortunately, the stripe's mid-zone, where your index finger is supposed to land while taking a photo, is small and unreliable. It's too easy to press the volume plus or volume minus buttons by mistake, rather than the shutter key, and potentially end up with a failed photo. On the bottom, there's the inevitable micro USB port. The left side houses a dual SIM slot which carries either up to two nano SIM cards or one micro SD card and a single nano SIM card. Folks, it's one or the other. You can't have two SIM cards and an external micro SD card in place simultaneously. Above the display, you'll find Acer's typical earpiece, which oddly enough looks like a miniature shower drain, along with a pair of light and proximity sensors and the front camera. The Acer Liquid JDS sports a 5-inch IPS LCD display with a 720p resolution and a pixel density of 294 pixels per inch. One would certainly expect better image quality of a screen with such parameters. Unfortunately, the picture looks somewhat jagged, as if there is always something wrong with it. That, the poor minimal brightness level, and the slightly colder colors are the meaningful problems to report here. Otherwise, the maximum brightness and viewing angles are great, which ensures comfortable visibility under most conditions. However, that curved glass layer is quite reflective, so don't expect miracles under direct sunlight. The Acer Liquid JDS runs Android 4.4.4 KitKat, which isn't the latest operating system release, but is reasonably up to date. On top of it, Acer layered a custom skin and a sizable portion of additional functionality. The launcher itself is pretty decent. It's lightweight and packs many useful widgets, while the oceanic built-in wallpapers do the liquid part of the phone's name justice. In addition, the Liquid JDS packs some no-nonsense practical functionality. In the App Switcher menu, you'll find two pages of customizable shortcuts leading to mini-apps. For starters, you can launch a navigation key, sidebar, notes, mini camera, mini Google Maps, a calc, a memo app, a stopwatch and a browser. These are super convenient and they will save you from wading through cluttered app drawers and home screens. Another software treat is the Acer Portal, which contains an app suite. These apps are cross-platform and are integrated with Acer's Bring Your Own Cloud service, which makes it easy to sync work and multimedia files between the smartphone and your personal computer. The final highlights are the scheduled power on and off setting, which is self-explanatory, and the quick touch gestures. These let you unlock the smartphone, play music, open the camera, or make a call by drawing a letter on the display while the phone sleeps. Quick touch unlock in particular allows you to unlock the device without reaching for the power key, but you have to get used to the gesture first. Acer's mid-range flagship presents a respectable spec sheet. It's powered by a 64-bit 1.5 GHz octa-core MediaTek MT6752M processor, which works in tandem with a Mali T760MP2 graphics unit and 2 GB of RAM. There are 16 GB of expandable built-in storage. In benchmarks, the Liquid JDS proved itself a reasonably capable player. Acer spec'd the smartphone fine, opting for a potent MediaTek chipset that makes it run quite well. Connectivity-wise, the Acer Liquid JDS is 4G LTE Category 4 connected. It's also a dual SIM device with that catch which we talked about earlier. The SIM slot can house either a micro SD card and a single nano SIM or up to two nano SIM cards. You can't run two SIM cards and a micro SD card simultaneously. Meanwhile, the stock browser is Google Chrome, which is familiar to anybody at this point, although there's another one available for use if you wish. Either way, the smartphone is speedy enough to let you browse comfortably, navigating, zooming and panning your way through the World Wide Web. Let's review the camera department. Acer's camera app is rather comprehensive. It has all the effects, filters and camera modes laid out in an organized menu that's easily accessible. Auto, HDR and panorama modes aside, the capture modes include beautification, best shot, bright magic, smile shutter, picture with sound, multi-angle view, presentation mode, dual shot and gourmet. The Liquid JRS features a 13 megapixel main camera with autofocus and a single LED flash. The photos are rather grainy, with a fair amount of noise in zoomed in images. As for the color reproduction, the red and purple hues are overrepresented, ending up with that typical purple tint that haunts budget smartphone cameras. But in gloomy weather, the light soaking HDR mode might just lead to a decent shot. Speaking of low light situations, the single LED flash which accompanies the camera is limited in its ability to illuminate objects in the dark, but as you can see from the indoor samples, it will suffice. For shooting videos, the maximum resolution you can go for is 1080p. Unfortunately, videos recorded with this phone are below the norm. And as for the 5 megapixel front camera, well, it doesn't really have what it takes to land that perfect selfie, but for video chatting and casual selfies, the front snapper is okay. The Liquid JRS is another Acer smartphone that features audio enhancements designed by DTS. As respectable as this may sound, the feature doesn't seem to shine in either loudspeaker or headphones output. We can't describe the audio reproduction as decidedly better than other smartphones in or outside of the Liquid JRS price class. Moreover, output from the Acer Liquid JRS single loudspeaker is very quiet. You may miss a fair bit of ringtones. As for video content, the Liquid JRS plays all popular formats of video files without a hitch. Call quality is the worst part of this phone. With an earpiece as quiet as this one, you won't be enjoying great calls and you will miss ringtones in noisier environments for sure. Voices are clear enough, but the output is simply too low. You will really have to stick the handset close to your ear to be able to make up anything. If you own a headset, you'll be good to go, but normal everyday talks will be a problem unless Acer does something for that muted pair of speakers. The Acer Liquid JRS lasted 8 hours, 32 minutes and 46 seconds in our battery test. This is a decent result, although one would expect it to last even longer due to the frugal 720p display and the sufficient 2300 mAh battery. The Acer Liquid JRS will be sold in the Europe, Middle East and African region at €300 unlocked. We don't know whether Acer plans on launching it in America. In this price range, Europeans have a wide choice of competing devices that outclass the Liquid JRS in most categories. One could simply pick up another flagship like the LG G2, Sony Xperia Z1, HTC One M7, Z1 Compact or the Samsung Galaxy S4 at about the same price. If you do this, you will set yourself with a noticeably superior experience. Thus, the Acer Liquid JRS seems very poorly situated on the market and practically begs for a price cut to stand a chance. This is Luis D from Phone Arena, thanks for watching our review.